Public Library System, and I'm here with Gene Yang. He is the author of many wonderful books, including American Born Chinese, Box of Saints, and his new one, The Green Turtle. The Shadow Hero?
The Shadow Hero, which tells the story
of the Green Turtle.
That's right. Yes.
And he is going to answer questions sent in by DC Public Library kids for us.
That sounds great.
That sounds
I'm
great.
Looking forward to it.
Excellent. The overwhelming question that kids have.
Okay.
Where do you get your ideas?
That's great. I get my ideas from my own life. So for instance, the very first project, the very first comic that I ever did as an adult is called Gordon Yamamoto, the King of the Geeks. You should not try to find this because it's terrible. But it's about a young man who gets a spaceship stuck in his nose and becomes friends with the alien that's driving the ship. Now, I have never gotten a spaceship stuck in my nose, but I have had a lifelong struggle with sinus problems. So, for some reason, every day of my life, at least one of my nostrils is plugged up. Like right now, it's this one, in case you're wondering. And the problem with that is there's never anybody to blame for that. You know, it's just something that you're born with. Yes. But one day I thought, what if there was something? And that's how that story came up. So even the weirdest ideas, I think, are rooted in my own. I started drawing when I was 2.
Okay.
From my mom's
home. Early.
So early. Yeah, but I didn't start drawing comics until I was in 5th grade.
Okay.
That's when I started reading them. And one of my favorite things about the comic book medium is that leap from being a reader to a creator is very easy. Anybody can do it.
And that kind of is what our kids want to know. You know, they want to know about how to make their own comics.
There are a couple of books that you could read. There's one called Adventures in Cartooning, which is amazing. And there's another one called Understanding Comics. Anybody who's starting off in comics ought to read those
books. I do have my favorite question that came in.
Okay.
It's from a little boy, he's 6 years old.
Okay.
He wants to know how you make the words fit in the bubbles.
Oh, that's hard. That's a really hard thing to do. You know, when I was starting off, what I would do is I would draw the bubbles first, and then I would write the words in, and you end up making the bubble, the words that kind of curve around, and they'll get smaller and smaller and smaller, and it's really terrible. So nowadays, what I do is, before I do any of the drawing, I figure out the words first. I figure out the words, and then I draw the balloons around them, and then I draw the words around them.
That you had an answer.
Yeah, it's actually, I feel like it's counterintuitive. You want to draw the picture first, but don't do it. Resist. Never.
Excellent. What was your very first drawing for a comic book?
My very first drawing? Well, my very first comic book that I did was with a friend named Jeremy Kuniyoshi. Brainstormed a story together, and the story was about this superhero named the Spade Hunter, who was sort of like Robin Hood. He wore all green, he had a cap with a little red feather in it, but instead of a bow and arrow, he actually had this discus of death that he would throw at people's heads. Right? That was the one innovation that we introduced.
I like it.
So we brainstormed these stories together. I would do all the pencils, he would do all the inks, and then we'd actually take photocopies and sell them at school. Yeah, it was fun.
The other question we get a lot is, do you have to be able to write and draw?
No, you absolutely do not. There are plenty of people who are working in comics today as professionals who only do one or the other. There are amazing writers who don't draw at all, and there are amazing artists who don't write.
Oh, that's kind of amazing.
They've been talking to writers of novels.
Okay.
And they said, how long does it take to write a novel? And the answer was many, many days.
Many, many days?
And, yes. Many, many
days.
Many, many days.
You know, I have novelist friends who put out a book a year, and it just makes me want to punch them. Can I say that?
Yes.
It seriously makes me want to punch them. Because
how long
a graphic
takes
novel
to
takes
a graphic
forever.
Novel?
It takes forever. Like so my last graphic novel is called Boxers and Saints. It's about 500 pages long, and it took me 6 years to get it. American Born Chinese took me 5.
Okay. Yeah. So, all right. Might be my favorite answer. And do you use spell check?
I absolutely use spell check. Yes. Yes, that's part of the reason why I do computer lettering, is because my own spelling is so atrocious that I have to use spell check.
Okay.
It's actually, my books are spell checked on multiple levels. They're spell checked by a computer, and then they're also spell checked by multiple editors. I can give you a list of comic books that I love as long as I really could. I'll give you a couple of them. I really like Bone by Jeff Smith. I think it's absolutely amazing. There's another one called The Land of Nod by Jay Stevens. It's hard to find nowadays, but it's also amazing. 100 Demons by Linda Barry. Jason Shiga has a book called Meanwhile. And then for little kids, Lark Pien, who colored my books, who colored Boxers and Saints in American War Chinese, did a wonderful children's comic called Long Tail Kitty.
Thank you so much for talking
to me. No, thank you. Thank you.